Hello everybody, welcome to the Chubby Channel. Today we got something special. Let's get fired up, I'm ready to go. So, what do we have? A big package, which arrived, which was opened by customs and brought to me by Taiwan Gun. Alright, let's see what's in there. So, at least if you know the title, if you saw the title, you know what's in here. So, the big difference here is the electronics involved with what we previously did, or were doing. So, what we have here is a Simon, whatever is the correct term. Simon, a pistol, a airsoft pistol, and the cool thing, this is the cool thing about it, the MOSFET edition. Yeah. Pistols normally are or were gas powered, red gas, green gas, which is butane and propane, I think, or CO2. We had the already, as you know, the electronic version of all the AAGs. Now, apparently, we are starting to get pistols that are running on electricity, which are do more than a 50 FPS muzzle velocity. So what do we get? We do get a free gift of BBs, which is 500 of 0.25. Well, the point to use them, you're only allowed to use them if they're biodegradable. I can't see anywhere that they are. So if not, they're test BBs, there's nothing you can do with them. And we got both the 0.25 and the 0.20 BBs, which might be interesting if we test the speed to see what the usable speed is with the pistol. Because this pistol is rated at a 200 FPS, which is not too high, but should be enough, at least especially for indoor purposes. So, what do we have in the box? We have a charging instruction, because it's a lithium battery. And as you know, lithium batteries tend to not like being mistreated too much. We get a target, which is nice, perfectly to put in front of a shoebox and to try out your aim. Perfect. We get a little booklet that explains you how to use it. All fine. Some nice packaging. And then we have the actual gun. Another couple of test BBs. You get a fast loader. You get a charger, I guess. Yes, this is a USB charger. And a lithium battery. And then obviously the gun itself, with a rod to clean the barrel. Okay, so first thoughts is the weight is pretty good. The balance is surprisingly well done. The stock is solid, huh? So there's no movement of the stock. Everything feels very solid. This is metal. I thought everything was going to be plastic, but this is metal. The handguard is plastic, but the top is metal. It's a bit top heavy as well, but I guess that's because there's a electricity and a piston inside to make it all work, which is, I'm very excited about that. I did not read the instructions, so I'm guessing that it's going to be pressing this button. And these two together. Right. So this button down releases the magazine. The magazine is not plastic, it's metal as well. Cool. That's that. And then obviously you're going to have to get the battery in somehow. So I'll read the manual. Let's see how we do that. The manual explains you where the front and the back is. Let's see. Load the battery into its position. So we have a gun release body button. So here we go. This explained you already a bit how it works inside. We have our barrel here. We have our adjustable hop-up here, which is quite interesting. And then the battery goes under the barrel here with a mini Deans plug. I don't know if you can see it. Yeah, you can see it. It's a mini Deans plug. Oh, cool. Interesting. So let's connect it up and see if we can get it working. Reason it's not a really problem is because the lithium batteries are normally shipped about 30% charged, at least they should. And there is, on one side there's a bit less space than on the other to insert the battery, and obviously the side I used was the wrong side first, but now I hope I know how to put it in. Okay, so voila, battery is in. Let's see if we can get this back in. All right, seems like it's working, so let's do a dry fire first. Not the fastest thing. That's all you would need, I guess, in a indoors environment. It's gonna be 200 FPS, which is perfect for, like I said, indoors. Not too fast, which is again perfect not to waste all your BBs at once. There, I think this is a capacity of about 30. The gun comes with one of them, but the mags are not the most expensive thing in the world either. So yeah, pretty fun thing. It's gonna be a nice backup. It's got a nice feel to it. It's a bit on the heavy side, just to be running around with it the entire day to use as your backup. But in an inside environment where you can only use pistols, this is gonna be awesome. And the thing is, and that's a cool thing about this one, you can easily add a light, a strobo, not a laser of course, but add something here. And because of the stock, it's not moving, so it's a solid stock, so it's not a blowback, makes it actually a bit more accurate, at least in my opinion, because the blowback will not tilt your gun backwards. The lack of blowback will make sure that your gun moves not as much. So in my mind, in practicality, this one is better. Like I said, a bit on the heavy side. Not sure on how heavy though. Does it say on the scale? So let's take the scale out. So normal kitchen scale, and let's see what the actual weight is. 800 grams on the dot. So it's a bit on the heavy side, but feels great. Looks amazing for what it cost. For anyone who wonders, this is the Saima CM25 MOSFET edition. Great little thing. Looking forward to testing it and getting out on the field. Thanks everyone, have a great day. I wanted to add something. I wanted to test the FPS and the rounds per second, and the actual noise the gun makes, to check how usable it is. To test it, we have our trusted chronograph here. We can test the meter per second, feet per second, and EULA, and you can select which BB and then round per second. And we are going to test the FPS on 20, crowns. 51st. Loaded it up. Single shot. See what it does. As you can see, it is between 190 and 210. All right, and let's see how fast he shoots. Make sure to put it on. Now, 15.9. And it is pretty loud. I have added, well, I have previously done a decibel meter test, and I will add that here. It's more than 100 decibels, so it's pretty loud. It's not a silent little thing, but it's great fun.